Good morning, students. Today, let us discuss about packaging of dairy products. Dairy products or milk products or lactisinia are the foodstuffs produced from milk of mammals. Important characteristics of packaging material that are used for packaging of milk includes the packaging material should prevent light passage, it should prevent water loss, it should prevent oxygen transmission, or it should have good barrier properties, in other words, shall offer resistance for microbial contamination. Let us first discuss about the conventional materials that are used for packaging of dairy products. Glass is one of the conventional material used long back. The glass may be transparent or opaque. It is used in the form of bottles, tumblers, jars, jugs, etc. The main advantage of using glass is that it has got good strength, rigidity, and its barrier properties are very excellent, especially to water and gas, and it is highly inert to chemicals. And at the same time, it is also non-toxic. The disadvantage of glass is that it is heavy in weight and highly fragile. The next conventional material used for packaging of milk is paper and paper-based products. Paper is basically cellulose-based and which is used in the form of box, bags, wrappers, cartons, cups, etc. The main advantage of paper and paper-based products are it is light in weight, it can be printed, it is of low cost, and it can be easily disposed. The disadvantage is that it has got low wet strength and low tear strength. Conventional material used is tin plate. It is made up of a thin sheet that is about 0.025 mm thick of mild steel coated on both the sides with a thin layer of pure tin. It is desirable to have an internally lacquered can, that is a coating should be provided inside the can which could prevent the material from corrosion. The main advantages of tin-coated sheets are that it has got a good strength and excellent barrier properties. The disadvantage are it's costly, heavy in weight, difficult in closing the lid of container, and disposal is also difficult. The next conventional material used is aluminium foil. The common thickness of the foil that is used is 0.012 to 0.015 mm. To increase the corrosion resistance, it is usually coated with a lacquer or a thin film of plastic, especially for packaging of dairy products. The main advantages of using an aluminium foil is it has good barrier properties, it is also grease proof, it is shrink proof, and it is odorless, tasteless, hygienic, and also non-toxic. It is also opaque to light. As we know that for packaging of especially milk or milk-based products, the packaging material should be opaque to light. Otherwise, the protein present in milk may undergo degradation. And the demerits or disadvantages of aluminium foil is that it has got low tear strength. It is susceptible to strong acids and alkalis. And these aluminium foils are used in the form of wrappers, cartons, and boxes. This is the most widely used packaging material for the packaging of milk and milk products. It is plastics. Plastics, say cellophane or cellulose-based plastics can be used, as well as the conventional plastics like polyethylene, polypropylene, polystyrene, PVC. All these also could be used for packaging of dairy products. Advantages of using plastics is that it is of low cost, it is easy to fabricate, and the barrier properties are very good as far as plastics are concerned. They have very good barrier properties towards moisture, and they confer protection to dairy products against the attack of microorganisms and insects. There are no pinholes present. though it can be packed in very thin films, pinholes present are very less, or there are no pinholes. In other words, they are not reused, or in other words, it can be recycled. The demerits or the disadvantages of using plastic is that the product compatibility is poor, low barrier, plastic deterioration, or in other words, they are non-biodegradable, and lack of resistance to heat, and fragile at low temperatures. Most of the plastics, as we know, that they have got a TG below sub-zero. That is, especially the plastics that are used in packaging of milk have got a TG less than 0 degrees Celsius. And when these milk products are packed or stored in refrigerators, they could be fragile, or since they reach a temperature below the glass transition temperature where the material is found to be or found to exhibit brittle behavior. And failure to obtain a perfect seal and removal of all air before packaging may lead to spoilage. So these are considered as the drawback of using plastics material. The next packaging material used for packaging of milk and milk products is laminates, or in other words, Tetra Pak. Tetra Pak consists of paperboard, polyethylene, and aluminium foil. Paperboard is mainly present in cartons. It provides strength, stability, and smoothness to the printing surface. Polyethylene, it is found to protect against outside moisture and enables paperboard to stick to the aluminium foil. The next layer is aluminium foil. It protects against oxygen and light to maintain the nutritional value and flavor of food packed in at ambient temperature. This is a picture of a Tetra Pak. Tetra Pak consists of many layers. The first two layers are made of polyethylene, followed by aluminium foil, then paperboard, and finally polyethylene. These laminates are mainly used to strengthen the film material, to improve barrier properties, to improve grease resistance, and to provide a surface that will heat seal. This packaging material used for packaging of milk products is vegetable parchment paper. This possesses a high grease resistance and water resistance, and it resembles that of a parchment, which is often used as a food wrapper. And it's actually prepared by sizing the paper with sulfuric, that is, unsized paper is treated with sulfuric acid so that the surface gets gelatinized, and then it is washed and dried. So this paper, we call it as parchment paper, and it has got a high resistance to grease, and but the drawback is it does not possess good barrier to oxygen. Now let us discuss about the packaging of fluid milk. The fluid milk is one with that we get in packed films, say like Avin or Arogya milk. These milk are nothing but pasteurized milk. The important characteristics of pasteurized milk is that milk has a tendency to absorb the flavor from its surroundings. There is a high risk of contamination, especially when we handle a liquid milk. And milk is also prone to oxidation when exposed to sunlight. So the packaging material should be opaque enough to prevent the passage of sunlight through the packaging film. The materials that are widely used for packaging of fluid milk include glass and plastics. Plastics especially used are low-density polyethylene, or linear low density polyethylene, or we can go for a combination of LDP and LLDPE in the ratio of 5:1 to 4:1 ratio. And other materials that are used for packaging of fluid milk includes coated paperboard, wax coated paperboard, the ESL, which is nothing but extended shelf life pouch. The pouches are placed in a reusable multi-trip plastic crates, and the crates are made of high density polyethylene or polypropylene and are nestable and stackable. Next, let us discuss about packaging of fermented dairy products. Fermented dairy products include curd, butter, ghee, etc. The requirement of a packaging material for use for packaging of these fermented dairy products include: it should prevent moisture loss, improve appearance, protect against microorganisms and prevent oxygen transmission. Under the fermented dairy products, first let us take up the case of ghee. The packaging material used for ghee is tin container, lined carton with flexible laminated polyethylene as inner liner, polyester, nylon 6, and the use of high barrier materials such as ethylene vinyl alcohol copolymer, laminated polyethylene cover. So these are the packaging material used for packaging of ghee. Next, fermented milk product is cheese. The packaging material used for cheese is tin plate containers, plastic laminates or containers made out of co-extruded LLDPE, nylon and LLDPE combination, co-extruded LLDPE, ethylene vinyl alcohol, LLDPE combination or co-extruded film based on PVDC, polyvinylidene chloride, as the core material. Laminates of metallized polyester, co-extruded nylon based films are also used. Film laminates based on polylactic acid and petrochemical plastics are also used. Starch and cellulose based materials are also used in packaging of cheese. Soft cheese can be packed in PLA paper combination and cellophane based films. The next fermented product, dairy product, is curd. Curd is usually packed in injection molded polystyrene and polypropylene hips cup with aluminium foil based peelable lids. The shelf life of the curd that is packed in such containers is about 10 days under refrigeration. The plastic cups are light in weight, easy to handle and are hygienic. Some private dairies, they pack curd in LDPE pouches of 200 ml capacity. The next material is butter. Butter is usually 85% fat. It is packed using either vegetable parchment paper, aluminium foil with lacquer coating, placed in plastic laminated paper board carton. Polypropylene and ABS plastic cups can also be used. Tin and aluminium containers are also used. Replacement of the current polyethylene bottles by BioPE bottles. In addition, Innovia manufactures paper cellophane based films that are suitable for packaging of butter. BioPP is not commercially available in the market but can be used in future to replace polypropylene. The recent trends in packaging of dairy products include controlled atmosphere and modified atmosphere packaging. Modified atmosphere packaging is replacement of air inside the pack with either a single gas or a mixture of gases like carbon dioxide or nitrogen, whereas controlled atmosphere storage refers to constant monitoring and adjustment of gas levels within gas tight stores or containers. It provides an optimum atmosphere for increasing the shelf life and quality of the food. Modified atmosphere has proven to be the best packaging method for prolonging the shelf life of cheese samples in terms of microbial attack and sensorial aspects. That is, the taste of the cheese that is packed in MAP is as that of the fresh cheese. The next type of packaging is active packaging. Active packaging incorporates additives into the packaging film or within the packaging containers by which the package, product and the environment interact to prolong the shelf life or to enhance the safety or sensory properties as well as to maintain the quality of the food that is being packed. When microbial systems such as silver-based or triclosan is incorporated into the conventional polymers, such packaging we call it as active packaging. Next, let us discuss about the bio-based materials that are used for packaging of dairy products. Why should we go for a dairy why should we go for bioplastics in packaging of dairy products? The bioplastics may be preferred because of high moisture and barrier properties than high density polyethylene bottles and polyethylene laminated bottles. when compared to PHB, polyhydroxybutyrate. So polyhydroxybutyrate could be a better choice when compared to the conventional materials. Then high carbon dioxide permeability, which is suited for cheese, storage of cheese, which is possible with polylactic acid. The viability of lactic acid bacteria contained in yogurt. And there is also 50% reduction in the use of fossil fuel feedstock, as well as reduction of 1.62 kilogram of carbon dioxide per every 1 kilogram of polyethylene replaced. Next, let us discuss about the bioplastics that could be used in packaging of the dairy products. First one is polylactic acid, which is a natural polymer which is derived from cornstarch. The advantages of using polylactic acid are: it is found to degrade within weeks. It has got high stability, transparency, wide, it can withstand wide temperature range. It is also resistant to UV light. It is convenient to use, and carbon footprint of PLA 2.16 gram as compared to 720 grams per ml of serving of polyethylene. It also has got high mechanical properties, that is high tensile strength and modulus. This picture shows about the packaging design used for packaging of milk. Thermoformed bottle, tagged foil for tamper evident, top lid with flip top closure, multiple use and convenient. The next material that could be used for packaging of dairy products is polyhydroxybutyrate. Polyhydroxybutyrate is a material which is obtained by microbial fermentation, that is bioprocess of whey, which is created during cheese production. It will be used as a biodegradable packaging material called whey pack that can be tailored to specific dairy products. One important goal of Life Whey Pack European project was to obtain cheese packaging that is 100% biodegradable, which would enable a lower environmental impact. And also it fulfills the requirement of product protection, and also it is economically viable. The project's second goal was to figure out what to do with all the surplus whey derived from cheese making. Polymer is obtained by injection molding process, which will be used for dairy products, especially packaging of cheese. Polyhydroxybutyrate is found to have better oxygen barrier properties when compared to polypropylene and polyethylene terephthalate, and also has got better water vapor barrier properties when compared to polypropylene, and fat and odor barrier properties that are sufficient for use in food packaging application. The next material used is calimer. The benefit of using calimer is there is a drop in the use of fossil oil and also reduced impact on the environment. Calimer is nothing but a chalk based material. Chalk is a finely grained limestone, which is usually reduced to a powder. Limestone is formed from the shells of corals, mussels, she shells and other sea creatures made from chalk or calcium. A packaging material called calimer is made up of at least 40% by weight of chalk, as well as plastics, polyethylene and polypropylene. The plastic binds the material and make it durable and flexible. The calcium carbonate provides strength and stiffness. The material is used in packaging system is relatively expensive when compared with the traditional materials. Next is fully renewable carton packaging by Tetra Pak. Carton packaging made entirely from plant-based materials. In Tetra Pak, Tetra Rex bio-based cartons, LDPE is used to create the laminate film for packaging material, and the neck of the opening together with high-density polyethylene used for cap are all derived from sugarcane. A Tetra Rex bio-based packaging with a twist cap OSO34 opening is manufactured solely from a combination of plastic derived from plants and paper boards. The packaging material incorporating natural biopolymers such as lignin, which are found to improve the mechanical and barrier properties of starch-based packaging, are discussed here. It is made of casting from sago palm starch as film matrix, glycerol as plasticizer, and by adding lignin isolated from oil palm black liquor as reinforcement material. So basically this is a composite which is made from sago palm starch, plasticized with 30% glycerol and reinforced with lignin. Due to hydrophilicity of starch, the packaging film has poor barrier to oxygen and moisture. Some commercially available edible film varieties are already on the market, but these are made of starch, which is more porous and allows oxygen to seep through its microholes. The milk-based packaging, however, has smaller pores and thus can create a tighter network that keeps the oxygen out. Next material is lactase. Bio-based plastic pellets made from milk protein, that is casein, which can be transformed into water-soluble film that is found to totally degrade within 18 days, biodegrade within 18 days. The thermoplastic pellet of milk protein is processed into a product by thermoforming process. It can be used as an edible pack for packaging of milk-based products. It is found to have high oxygen barrier. The cosmetic company solely uses waste milk as a suitable for waste milk, not suitable for human consumption, for making it as a packaging material, but which is supposed to still contain valuable substances that can be used for packaging material. The company focuses on the concept natural freshness cosmetics in sustainable packaging. On the other hand, the material is biodegradable and only non-food milk is being involved in the production process and thus minimize the waste of still usable resources. Next is biopolymer lining in paper-based products. Paper-based products are preferred in packaging mainly because of their biodegradability. But the paper possesses poor moisture barrier property because of the presence of free OH group and cellulose. Thus, this problem of moisture absorption or moisture barrier property, poor moisture barrier property, is overcome by having a liner of ethylene vinyl alcohol for oxygen barrier. But the problem is it absorbs moisture and water absorption is minimized by having a polyolefin coating, which makes it a non-biodegradable material. Hence, polyethylene, polyvinyl alcohol coatings are being replaced by biopolymers such as milk proteins like casein, whey protein, gluten, soy protein, etc. This slide shows about the packaging machineries used in packaging of milk. We have mechanical filling, overwrapping machines, cup filling machines, and form fill and sealing machines. What limits the biopolymers from packaging of dairy and dairy products is cost, use of land, low mechanical strength, thermal instability, limited long-term stability, poor heat stability, low water and oxygen barrier property, high brittleness, and poor adhesion.